Ah, yeah. Okay, you ready? Okay.
Ready? Thank you for letting us be part of this brainstorm. What a wonderful idea. Thank you for making it happen. I'm Rick Maxson. This is Karen Maxson, and together we are Uke 66, because why not?
Right?
Because, well, we're playing our ukuleles, and of course we're from Springfield, the birthplace of Route 66, so we thought that was pretty cute.
And so here's what we do songs. We're peering at the phone to see what the comments are.
Yeah,
so sorry.
Which makes us feel even more enclosed than we already are. And as I look at the songs that we chose for tonight, most of the songs have to do with wishing you were somewhere else.
Right? Or that circumstances were different.
Yeah.
So, all right.
Here we go.
This is by Israel Kamaka Viva Ole. And he's the one who wrote Somewhere Over the Rainbow that we all love on the ukulele.
Or at least interpreted it.
Yeah, yeah, interpreted it. So this is called Hele Antu Kauai. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
3, 4. There's a place that I recall. Not too big. In fact, it's kind of small.
Calling me back home.
When I was young and not too smart, I left my home looking for a brand new start. To find a place that was better still. And now I know I never will.
Hele onto Kauai.
used to play. The canyons of Waimea, standing all alone. The magic of the Garden Isle is calling me back home. And now that it's 7 o'clock, we can start.
Okay, it's 7 o'clock. We're starting for reals now. Okie doke. Ready?
Yeah. Thank you so much, again, Eddie, for organizing this. And for the people who have come before us, be sure, if you didn't see them, be sure to look at the videos we've had. Eddie started things off with his acoustic guitar and his percussion. By Eric and Jasper. Yes, yeah. It's just incredibly listening to it just speaks to your soul.
It really does.
Yeah, and Steve, what wonderful! Yeah, I just wanted to come to the house that you say that you sang about.
I wanted to drink.
Yeah, and David, my colleague from Drury University. Are you feeling some community? I kind of am.
Yeah, I am too. This is wonderful. Okie doke. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. No. Sorry.
You need another instrument?
Yeah, because that's how it goes.
Okay.
Sorry.
Karen and I love playing these things, but what we like even more is other people making their own music. Ukulele is a great gateway to making your own music if you're not doing it already. You know, during these days, you might take up a new skill.
That'd be nice.
Ukulele would be a great thing to take up.
You ready?
Oh, I'm ready now.
Okay, we're ready now. Yeah.
No. Okay.
Janet, we love Hawaii too. Okay, ready? Here we go.
It's a marvelous night for a moon dance, with the stars up above in your eyes. A fantabulous night to make romance, neath the cover of October skies. And all the leaves on the trees are falling to the sound of the breezes that blow. And I'm trying to please to the calling of your heartstrings that play soft and low.
And all the
thank you. till the morning's come.
Nice job, honey.
And I know time is just right. And straight into my arms you'll run. And when you come, my heart will be waiting to make sure that you're never alone. There and then my dreams will come true, dear. There and then I will make you my own.
And every time I touch you, you just tremble inside. I know how much I want you, that my love I can't hide.
Can I just have one more moon dance with you, my love?
Here's a great story. We want to tell you a little story about how Missouri has a wonderful place in the history of ukulele. So back in the early part of the 1900s, there was a young man who lived in Hannibal, Missouri, and his name was Cliff Edwards. And he really wanted to play the piano in saloons in St. Louis, but it was World War I, and the pianos in saloons weren't really in good working condition. So this new instrument had just come over from Hawaii, and it was called the ukulele. And so Cliff Edwards took it up, and he became quite good, in fact, and he played around the saloons, the bars and such. And one saloon keeper couldn't remember his name, so he started calling him Ukulele Ike. And so Ukulele Ike, when you see somebody has said hi to you and you haven't talked to him in so long, hi Olivia. Anyway, Ukulele Ike became very good and very famous. And he had a friend who was also from Missouri. And this friend had moved out to the West Coast. And he was making movies. And he had a part for his friend Cliff that he wanted him to play. And so he gave Cliff a call and he said, hey, I've got this part in a movie for you. And I like you for this part because every time I hear you sing, I hear a smile. And so that's how this boy from Hannibal, Missouri, Cliff Edwards, also known as Ukulele Ike, became the voice of Jiminy Cricket.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. Your heart is in your dream. No request is too extreme. When you wish upon a star, as dreamers do, fate is kind. It brings to those who love the sweet fulfillment of their secret longing. Like a bolt out of the blue, fate steps in and sees you through. When you wish upon a star, your dreams come true. Like a bolt out of the blue, fate steps in and sees you through. When you wish upon a star, your dreams come true. Night night, Pinocchio.
Good job, honey.
Thank you.
All right. Yeah, elbows.
You know, you don't think you can feel a sense of community over the internet until you're right, you see?
Yeah.
See something you've...
Yeah.
One of you has written.
Yeah.
And you see a name.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
What is this? Oh, okay.
I think being secluded has started to affect us. We're getting all teary-eyed about stuff. So, we hope everybody's doing well out there. We're switching out ukuleles. Yeah.
It's hard to say if, what you know, during this time, you want to take up a new skill, ukulele's a great... We'd love to see you pick up a ukulele and start playing. There's lots of lessons online on YouTube, and some of them are actually good. Who's the guy that we would recommend?
Brad Bordessa.
Yeah, Brad Bordessa. Go look. He's got 5 to 7, I guess, beginner lessons. He's a wonderful teacher, and it's good sound music.
Also, the library, if you're in Springfield, Greene County, the library has... a service called lynda.com, and Daniel Ho is a wonderful ukulele player, and he has he's from Hawaii, and he has a lesson on there. It's a couple hours long, so okay,
if you don't have a ukulele, contact us. We'll loan you one of ours.
So we're about to do a song that Rick wrote. We are lucky to be involved with the Springfield Sister Cities Association, and we traveled to Isasaki, Japan, one of our sister cities, twice, once in 2015 and once in 2017. And we have an ensemble that will be going back to perform at a music festival. So we feel pretty lucky about that. After our first visit, Rick came home, and we were so...
taken.
We were so taken with the whole thing. He wrote a song called Isasaki Spring. And then we entered as a group, as Uke 66, and also we entered his song for best song in the International Ukulele Contest in Hawaii. And we traveled there in February, and we won our group division, which was really nice.
Elbows,
yeah, congratulations. So we're pretty excited about that. And this is the song we played. It's called Isasaki Spring. Thank you.
It's the Sake Spring.
All right. Well, you ready for this one?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So we have to get all geared up here. It's rare we use a capo, but...
One of the nice things that we really enjoy about the ukulele, it's a great form of expression. You can accompany yourself, and it mostly makes you feel good in surprising ways. It can.
Yeah, and you know, one of the things about the ukulele that makes it so is called something called reentrant tuning. And what that means is that in most ukuleles, the top string is higher than the other strings. So it starts like that, and it just sounds happy. So that's why they say that the ukulele is a happy instrument. And in fact, they say you can't play a sad song on a ukulele, but that doesn't mean you can't play an angry one. 2, 3, 4. I cut my bangs with some rusty kitchen scissors. I screamed his name till the neighbors called the cops. I numbed the pain at the expense of my liver. Don't know what I did next. All I knew I couldn't stop. Word got around to the barflies and the Baptists. My mama's phone started ringing off the hook. I can hear her now saying, refreshing. So,
Are we?
I hope we are. We're having a good time, even if we're not.
We're probably going to keep playing, even if we're not on.
Yeah. That's what we do.
We have time for, I think, a couple more songs. And this is what would happen in an imaginary meeting between Don Ho and Rick Maxson. Maybe maybe a medley, a ukulele medley would come up that sounds like this.
Yeah.
Down by the shack, by the sea, there's a bunch of jolly good boys you will see. Scene. shack by the sea. There's a bunch of jolly good boys you will see. From the shack by the sea. Don't feel them when your ship sails out to sea. Well, they'll be looking for just a little fee down by the shack by the sea. Upset, it starts to grunt like a pig, but you know you're gonna love it. It's an unwritten law. It's a huma huma nuka nuka apa wa ah. Here we go. Huma huma nuka nuka apa wa ah. Sweet harmony, sing and shout, or just stand in awe of the huma huma nuka nuka apa wa ah. Sing it! Huma huma nuka nuka apa wa ah. Huma huma nuka nuka apa wa ah.
State fish.
The Hawaiian state fish. Huma huma nuka nuka apa wa'a. So we're coming up on the end of our time. We're gonna do this one song. They say this is the free bird of ukulele players. We've enjoyed our time with you. Thank you. Thank you.
what you dreamed of. Dreams really do come true.
Guys.
Mahalo nui.
Mahalo nui.
Stick around because Paul Ferris is next.